President of the Republic of Croatia, Prime Ministers of the Republic of Slovenia, the Grand Duchy of Luxembourg, and the Republic of Serbia, President of the European Council, President of the National Council, former Presidents, Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Slovenia, Excellencies, Ministers, esteemed guests, spoštovane dame in gospodje. It gives me a great pleasure and honor to extend to you a very warm welcome to the 10th Bled Strategic Forum entitled Visions of New Partnerships. Welcome to sunny Slovenia, dobrodošli na Bledu. At the outset of this year's forum, we have just listened to the Slovenian Police Orchestra and the guest string section performing the BSF team, as well as the song Time to Rise, featuring vocalist extraordinaire Madame Daria Schweiger. Back in 2006, when we were organizing the first forum, we could not have predicted either its long-term success or the directions it would take. Over the past 9 years, the forum has grown from a regional conference into an important annual gathering, a successful platform addressing globally relevant topics and attracting prominent intellectuals from politics, business and academia, as well as young professionals from all over the world. And with maturity, it has also gained a clear vision, seeking to forge new partnerships and strategies designed to confront the most pressing issues of today's Europe and the world. Today, it is clear that the Bled Strategic Forum reflects the dynamics of the Slovenian foreign policy and resonates with the vibrations and energies of leadership, confidence, creative power, success, and energy. Beyond any doubt, we will continue our deliberation in an equally aspiring way. Visions and partnerships, alongside with trust and values, have become increasingly pressing issues in our changing world at national, regional, and global levels. Never before has the world been a greater need of partnerships aimed at overcoming the crisis and obstacles to development. Hence, if we wish to progress and live in a different, better world, we need to work together and look for effective solutions. We need strong political will, courage, and wisdom. We have to change the paradigm of distrust and regain mutual trust through partnerships. Partnerships are an inevitable foundation of ensuring cooperation and achieving common goals through inclusive dialogue and harmonized action. The 2015 Bled Strategic Forum therefore aims at exploring the importance of strong partnerships and searching for answers or what happens if visions are scarce. This year's debate will address numerous topics, such as the changing security environment and the current international political situation, the power of intercultural dialogue, development as global partnership, efforts for prevention and elimination of sexual violence in conflicts, fights against impunity, rapidly changing social structure and aging society, and the Western Balkans as a region at the center of geostrategic deliberation. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me now in welcoming the Slovenian Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Karel Erjavec, who will deliver his welcome address. Minister, please, the floor is yours.
President of Slovenia, Mr. Pahor, President of Croatia, Madam Grabar-Kitarović, President of the European Council, Mr. Tusk, Prime Ministers, Ministers, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, welcome to Bled and thank you for joining us at the 10th Bled Strategic Forum. 10 years ago, the forum was launched with a vision to bring together different decision makers to encourage open debates and search for new ideas and solutions. In all these years, we had the privilege of meeting many new friends and partners. We have built new relations in many different fields. With this in mind, we want to dedicate this year's Bled Strategic Forum to partners and partnerships. If we have a critical look at the world, we can see different problems and open issues. Global and regional security are facing many challenges. The world economy is still recovering from global crisis. Europe is coping with one of the biggest migration flows in history. None of these issues can be addressed without a strong and efficient international partnership. Slovenia's foreign policy has always been one of cooperation, friendly relations, and multilateral efforts. I'm pleased to say that these principles are also reflected in the new strategy of the Slovenian foreign policy. It has been adopted last month, and it will help us address the changing relations in the international community. We have focus on three pillars of foreign policy: security, peaceful politics, and prosperity. These three elements are not only of key importance for a national state, they are also the common goals of the global international community. Regarding the security, I want to stress Slovenia's activities in the United Nations, NATO, and the OSCE, including our participation in the peacekeeping operations and conflict prevention missions. Of course, Slovenia is also a part of global efforts to fight terrorism, violent extremism, and radicalization. Slovenia is a strong supporter of all disarmament efforts. It plays an important role in the global demining activities through the humanitarian organization ITF. We also believe that full respect for human rights and fundamental freedoms is an important part of national and international security. The same goes for the protection of minorities, children, women, and the elderly. At the same time, the international community should give full support to the system of international criminal justice, which is an important element of conflict prevention. Lastly, we must not overlook the importance of the full respect of international law and international obligations, including bilateral agreements. Peaceful politics, as the second pillar of foreign policy, must of course start with good and friendly relations among neighbors. Open issues must be solved with dialogue and with full respect of given commitments. Bilateral relations with all countries in the region or in other continents should be dynamic, positive, and filled with substance. Slovenia strongly supports all mechanisms of peaceful resolution of conflicts. I would like to stress our activities regarding mediation, prevention of genocide, and the concept of the responsibility to protect. Peaceful politics should also be encouraged by supporting democracy, the rule of law, and intercultural dialogue. As the last segment of foreign policy, I would like to underline prosperity. This part of our activities is reflected in our membership in the EU and the OECD. In these organizations, we promote our national interests in dialogue with other member states. Enhancing economic cooperation is the guiding principle of Slovenia's economic diplomacy. It's all about opening doors, building trust, and looking for new partners between countries and between companies. We are proud to carry out this important task, and we are pleased by the positive feedback that we get from our businessmen. Finally, I would like to stress the importance of the post-2015 development agenda that will be adopted in New York next month. We also hope for the positive outcome of the Paris Conference on Climate Change, which is another big challenge for our common future. As I said before, we need partnerships to achieve these goals. Sometimes in bilateral relations, one honest and strong partner is enough. More often, almost 200 members of the United Nations are needed to make a global positive step forward. In conclusion, I would like to thank all the former Slovenian presidents, prime ministers, and minister of foreign affairs who have been the key players in the forum since 2006 and supported it as our common project. I would like to thank all the sponsors who are our valuable partners. They have helped the forum to grow and develop even in the years when economy and finance were in decline. And finally, I would like to commend the forum Secretary General Ambassador Bergant, his dedicated team, and the colleagues from the Center for European Perspective. They make our Bled partnership possible. Thank you for your attention and thank you for coming.
Thank you, Minister, for this thorough insight into the Slovenian foreign policy. This year, the fifth Young Bled Strategic Forum, under the title Partnership of Visions, brought together 35 young individuals from all over the world and of different backgrounds. Diplomats, entrepreneurs, civil servants, prominent representatives of the non-governmental and academic institutions, think tanks, and researchers, who have all demonstrated a great leadership qualities and potential in their respective fields of activity. During the weekend, they have engaged in panel debates and workshop projects dedicated to innovative entrepreneurial environments, environmentally friendly development, and security on the internet. I've been told that they forge for new friendships and partnerships and contacts that they will use in the future. And that was also one of our main goals of the event. Special thanks for the successful Young BSF go to the program director, my colleague and friend Simona Leskovar, and her Young BSF team. Ladies and gentlemen, 2 weeks ago, the Lonely Planet website revealed the places that every traveler should visit and placed Bled to the definite bucket list of world's top tourist destination. With its emerald green lake, picture postcard church, a medieval castle clinging to a rocky cliff, and some of the highest peaks of the Julian Alps as backgrounds, they described Bled as a magical place, a small heaven in the heart of Europe. An idyllic landscape, the welcoming people, and infinite peace are the main qualities of Bled. As such, it provides a perfect setting for high-level meetings and stimulating discussions. This peaceful oasis and mystical place will hopefully evoke your pleasant memories and the desire to return. And who can better present Bled than its mayor? Mr. Janis Pfeiffer has been a loyal friend of the forum since its second edition in 2007. Mr. Mayor, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Ambassador Bergant. It always really is a great pleasure for me to address you here from a place where I'm standing here as Tito's pioneer in 62. Probably it's not the politically correct thing, but it's true. It's the same hall, and I'm still here, and I have quite a responsible job now, being elected, as most of you were elected or appointed by someone to run your places good. We always forget what I always stress about the common people. Bled is also a municipality. It's a local authority. It's a local community. 8,200 people. They live here, they go to school, they work, they are born, they go from this world as any other place, and we mostly live on tourism. And tourism is not good if there is no peace in the world. This year we have the horrible refugee crisis. At the end, local communities will get them on their backs. Don't forget about that. All our budgets are very short. Most of municipalities in the world are bankrupt or at the edge. It's very hard to meet ends. So every investment to social structure, to anything, is a good way to make people's life easier and better. Here, I'm very proud today, but last year, if you remember those who were here, we were demonstrating because the road system in Bled, the state road system, is appalling. And it does not deserve, a place like this does not deserve it. And I must say that today we opened the first 500 meters of the new northern bypass road. So in 2 years, you travel through Bled much easier, at least on one side. And we took a credit and paid it by ourselves, but this will be our share in the new full project. And I was among all dignitaries here, our present and ex-presidents, prime ministers, ambassadors, colleague mayors, all you highly respected people. The most I was happy today to meet our Minister of Infrastructure because we opened this road. And he promised, and here is the Prime Minister, you'll put his 2 million in the budget for next year. Otherwise, we might change mind. But, well, Bled is really beautiful, as Ambassador said. And this is sort of a natural atmosphere surroundings for optimism. I hope you'll get some of it. And you have a very nice place to enjoy the nature, the culture, the food, the drinks, but most of all, enjoy each other. Please meet each other, talk to each other. Here, everyone can talk to everyone. And use this opportunity to the benefit of all of us. I wish you a most pleasant stay. I hope you will return home with good memories. It was never so hot before at this meeting. Normally we have rain, which is fruitful for some countries. For some means floods, but anyway. But I hope you'll take home a good message and that you will tell your people that we wish to welcome them all here to share this beauty and to share this world, which is only one for all of us. Doesn't matter the borders, municipal or state. It's one sun, one sky for all of us. Thank you very much and enjoy your time and welcome back. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This year's Business Bled Strategic Forum will highlight the essence of visions, trust, and partnerships in business, essential to generating adequate social capital and sustainable economic growth. These elements were the cornerstones of the debate during the Business BSF. We will discuss the importance of developing European transport infrastructure, particularly cleaner technologies, and the need for partnerships between countries and the effective coordination of macroeconomic policies, which have become a new engine of growth. Furthermore, we will talk about the transatlantic trade and investment partnership in the light of numerous crises raised by civil society and about the tourist industry outlook up to 2020, the role and position of Europe on the global map of tourist destination and its relations with the rapidly growing markets of Asia and the Pacific. Ladies and gentlemen, despite a tough economic situation, 40 domestic and foreign corporate partners and sponsors once again recognize the importance of the forum, granting us their unconditional trust and offering full support. Allow me to thank especially to our three strategic partners, BMW Group Slovenia, Generali, Enrico. And now I would like to invite our keynote speaker, Prime Minister of the Republic of Slovenia, Dr. Miro Cerar, to take the floor. Please, Mr. Prime Minister.
Dear presidents, prime ministers, excellencies, dear ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, welcome to the Bled Strategic Forum 2015. This year, several major milestones are to be remembered. The 17th anniversary of the end of the Second World War, the 17th anniversary of the United Nations, the 40th anniversary of the Helsinki Final Act, and of course, the 10th anniversary of this respective forum. Milestones like this are an opportunity for rethinking the past and present, setting paths for tomorrow, and formulating broader visions of the future. By looking back into the past, it is critical that we do not nurture our pains or pains of our predecessors that were caused by wars and other kinds of social conflicts and injustices. We must, above all, take care that these pains are not transferred to the new generations, not to become personal or ideological burden for their future. Instead, morals and lessons from the past must be learned in order not to repeat tragic historical mistakes. In this spirit, we must further develop, respect, and fulfill our human rights and duties, democratic values, rule of law, and other developed civilizational standards. The year 2015 is one of the most complex, volatile, and thus challenging in the last decades, on European as well as on global scale. The modern plague of well-organized, ferocious terrorism has reached global impact, undermining not only peace and proper functioning of countries and regions, but also forcing millions of people to flee their homes and become refugees on foreign continents. Migration has become one of the most dramatic global challenges. It therefore requires a thorough rethink of our political strategies, which imply ethical, economic, social, as well as security dimensions. After awakening tragic developments in Central Mediterranean, Europe has responded to the migration problem relatively quickly. However, much more needs to be done. As we can see these days, masses of refugees are entering Europe. Hotspots are now shifting to the Balkans, where we are witnessing unprecedented numbers of people from different continents in search for safety and better life. An unfortunate mixture of survivors whose homes became unsafe to live in, and those who simply strive for a better future. And it's now high time to pay all our attention to this serious problem, as it could otherwise seriously endanger the stability in many European countries. The world, as we know, is changing fast. While experiencing fast economic integration, political divisions are on the run. Global economic crisis boosted protectionism and populism, and thus changed many political landscapes. It changed Europe as well. Unstable situation in Ukraine still calls for a permanent solution. Minsk agreements are not yet fully implemented, and the issue of Crimea remains unresolved. More effort needs to be done to secure stability and prosperity of the Western Balkans. The region in our neighborhood needs an impetus for political cooperation and economic growth. And in this part of Europe, especially, positive solutions have to be promoted, progress rewarded, and agreements respected. In the European Union, the financial crisis resulted in serious economic and social divergence among its members, introducing new divisions. The crisis that eventually made the Union more integrated and resilient had also exposed its old weaknesses that have to be addressed. Rising populism boosted skepticism and eroded trust and solidarity of the people. Take it or leave it solutions
and initiatives towards Europe à la carte certainly do not contribute to a common solution. Ladies and gentlemen, the world of today is so interdependent that permanent and sustainable solutions cannot be found by isolationism, glorifying national self-interests, or imposing the will of one on another. More than ever, partnerships are needed to find compromise and solutions acceptable for all. It is above all on us, leaders, to take responsibility to find solutions for new partnerships and of tomorrow. But we must also find a way to properly explain to the people how positive effects of cooperation outweigh the negative ones, that building fences can never be a sustainable solution, that having friends is an advantage, that agreed principles, rules, and commitments should be respected. Perhaps we should start the path with the most imminent problem of illegal migration. And one thing is sure, Fortress Europe is not a viable solution. So how should we tackle this challenge? Firstly, by helping those in real need, taking into account the absorption and integration capacity of respective countries and security challenges that illegal immigration entail. Secondly, common action to secure peace, stability and prosperity in the countries of origin and transit is urgently needed. The European Union already agreed on comprehensive measures. Now a swift implementation and cooperation with other global players is essential. Thirdly, we need to properly address challenges of aging population in Europe. People need to understand that our way of life cannot be sustained if we do not give a chance to our young generations on one hand, as well as a chance to people from other regions of the world to come to live and work here on the other. All this cannot be done by any one country alone. We all should take our share of responsibility, demonstrate solidarity and care for our common future. The same should go for a universal climate agreement. This summer is the hottest ever since the systematic temperature measurements were introduced. The weather is becoming extreme. Severe climate changes in recent years have proven that it is high time for a decisive response. It is true that our human understandings and actions are limited, but we must do as much as we can. We must soon reach a proper global agreement that will preserve our planet also for our grandchildren. Our colleagues in Paris, in cooperation with many others in the world, are doing their best to reach this new global partnership. If we want to preserve our future, they should be vigorously helped by all. Among the most tangible ways of building partnerships are trade agreements. They should definitely be given special attention. We need to further open the opportunities for trade while preserving the highest standards which protect our health, environment, social norms, and other key values. We should aim for common good while protecting the most vulnerable economies and businesses, as well as providing just and efficient way of resolving legal disputes. In this respect, I hope that negotiations on TTIP will soon be completed in a way that will be beneficial to partners from both sides of the Atlantic. Last but not least, as far as European Union is concerned, we need to strengthen trust among peoples and refocus on convergence in Europe to follow the vision our founding fathers have had. North, South, East, and West should stop thinking of which way is best for themselves and continue to look and strive for a sustainable solution for all. Differences in economic, social, and human resources, capabilities, and potentials should be taken into account in the way which leads to complementary solutions. We should strive for further integrations of those who wish to do so and a fair balance with those who do not, while preserving the unity and homogeneity of the Union. I'm confident that there is enough will and wisdom that this will be done. Partnerships are the ones that make us strong. Ladies and gentlemen, hard situations usually awake in us either the worst or the best. On one hand, we can confront our biggest challenges with negative emotions and reactions, such as fear or hatred. On the other hand, we can react to them in a positive manner by manifesting our virtues, such as courage, tolerance, empathy, and solidarity. I believe that truly successful leadership is always based on human virtues, despite social turbulences and difficult choices. I wish we would all be guided with this wisdom. It comes from those great thinkers who teach us that what really gives meaning to our lives is what we do good for the others. I wish you lots of lasting partnerships and good ideas while staying here in Bled. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, for your inspiring thoughts and vision. Ladies and gentlemen, a picture is worth a thousand words. So let's take a look back at the past forums with the projection of a short film prepared in cooperation with our partner Pristop, the leading independent marketing and corporate consultancy in the region of Southeast Europe. In accompaniment, we once again hear the Slovene Police Orchestra, joined by our guest string section. They will perform the Sinfonietta in D major, written by the young composer and BSF creative director, Mr. Žiga Pirnat. Please give a big round of applause for the Slovene Police Orchestra under the baton of Žiga Pirnat.